Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Having now downloaded Django in the previous tutorial, we're now ready to create a new Django project. Therefore, the plan in this tutorial is to create a new Django project, and then I'll take you through the process to verify if your Django project has been built successfully. It will be well worth your time making a note of this command, because this command is utilized to actually start a new Django project. Let me just take you through the command here. Now, in order for us to interact with Django, we need to tell or describe the fact we want to interact with Django. So here we're going to be utilizing the Django admin command. Later on, we will replace this with the manage.py function or the manage.py command. But for now, before we even start a project to interact with Django, we need to utilize the Django admin command here. Right, so now we've described the fact we want to interact with Django, we can now use additional commands. So we want to start a project. Now, if you are an English speaking student, then this is very easy to remember because we're utilizing language which is very descriptive of the task that we want to perform. We want to start a new project. So we use the command start project. And here we have the name of the project. Now you can change this to any name that you want to use. Here we're utilizing core, and then we have a space and then a full stop. So we need to tell Django where we want to create our new project. And the dot here is actually just referring to the current working folder. Now, if we wanted to change this to another folder, we could replace that and with a folder structure of where we want to actually store our project. Let's go back to Visual Studio Code. We're going to start off where we left in the previous tutorial. So we should have Django installed. Just double check. There we go. So we have Django 4.1.1 installed. Right. So Django admin and then start project and then the name of the project. So here I'm using core as the name of the project. And then I'm going to leave out the dot at the end. So notice what happens is that we create a new folder called core. And inside of that, we have a new folder called core, where the settings and other files can be found. Now you will probably interact with different Django projects, and the likelihood is that different projects will have different setups. So you may find that you will be working with a project with this type of structure, but it's very likely that at least at the beginning of your Django development, that you're going to be setting up the Django application within the folder here. So without the folder, within a folder. So we can go ahead and just delete that folder. Just go ahead and delete that. And let's try this again. And this time we use the full stop. So we can see that this time we have a new folder called core, as we've specified, that's the name. And then inside of here, you can find the settings and other files. The word project is used very loosely. I could describe this folder here as my Django project. I could also describe this folder here as my main or core project folder, hence the reason why I called it core. So if I say the project folder, I'm probably talking about this folder here. If I'm talking about the main project folder, I'm going to be talking about the project folder we've just created here. Having now created a new Django project, we're now ready to start the project up. So let's give this a go. Right. So in the previous step, we utilized the Django admin command in order to interact and communicate with Django. But you notice that when we create a new project, we created a new manage.py file. And that is essentially a wrapper around this command here so that we can now interact with the project utilizing manage.py. I will take you through the steps and explain a little bit more about the Django server later on in this section of the course. But for now, let's just go ahead and use a command to start a Django server. And that's going to allow us to interact with our project and check to see if our project has been installed correctly. So now what we can do is we can utilize the manage.py file instead of using the Django admin command. So I'm going to type in Python 3. If you're on Windows, you're probably just going to type in py. Okay, right, so Python 3 or py, and then we go ahead and use the manage.py. Notice I didn't write it all out, I'm used tab, and now I'm going to start the server by specifying the run server command. What we've done here is we've created a new Django server, and you can see that this server is being run at this address here. So I can copy that, go to my browser, and view the project. So back in my browser here, I'll type or just paste that in, and you can now see that the install works successfully. Congratulations, we're now ready to start our Django application or build our Django application. If you do have a problem at this point, then just work backwards. So first of all, double check that you're using the right URL to access the website. Secondly, make sure that the server is running in the first place. So you can see here that it does say that the starting development server has been started. So you may have an error on your screen. Double check that you've created the project successfully. And then back from that, double check that you've actually installed Django correctly. There may be issues with your browser, or potentially you have other advanced firewall issues. So that's something, unfortunately, I can't help you with.